Okay. Dance music. Wow, this is incredibly loud. I am definitely going to have to reduce the volume of this. Well, they're dead. Truly the most brutal photograph ever. I'm gonna need some alcohol after this. So that is the effectiveness of Seymour's revolver. It is very, very much useful. I don't know if there's anything actually in the nightclub. I think this is just a boss arena. So, okay. Now we have some time to kill. But we probably should go do this before TK gets away. First though, what have we here? I'll take it. Man, I wonder why that club music was so damn loud. It's actually still playing. Looking at the best way to get there. I guess this is the best way. I guess the arrow has the right idea for once. Oh, that's right. The zombies are gonna be all, like, angry again. Because it's nighttime again now. I forgot about that. And the silver strip. Away. Ride, Frank West. Ride like the wind. Or, you know, haul ass like the wind, I guess. Be like a donkey trailer truck and haul ass. My grandpa said that once. Thankfully, we have a faster way to get around. Thanks to our question mark murder of Chuck Green question mark, we have the ability to bike our way there. And let's see, where specifically is that? Okay, it's directly at the other end. The arrow's going fucking nuts trying to figure out the best way to mislead me into going the wrong direction. Arrow's like, oh, Jesus Christ. You got me, Frank. You got me. It is a little bit nauseating, the camera on that. Oh, jeez. So, TK's thugs are here. Thankfully, they're not wearing helmets or anything like that. Oh, hello. Oh, I guess that zombie's coming with me. Okay.
Not without me, Frank. You won't scoop me this time.
I probably should have taken off the ninja mask.
Rebecca, get down.
Hey, whoa! Careful with the money, fool! We don't got much left.
Hey, look, boss!
Not possible. Not gonna happen. We're taking off. Now!
You're not going anywhere, TK! Get this on tape, Rebecca!
Ah!
shit, we're fighting a helicopter. So, in order to fight the helicopter, you have to, throw stuff at it and not get hit by it. Oh my god! So generally, it's better to duck under it than what I was doing, which was to, you know, just eat it. Eat the rotor for breakfast. Hup. I believe that somehow there is an achievement for beating this helicopter without taking damage, which is fucking crazy, because that seems like it'd be really hard. That's cool though, I like this. This is a very entertaining idea for a boss fight. You can Dark Souls your way through it by dodging. Yeah! What now, TK?
What's he doing here? Isn't he the host of that show?
TK paid some pathetic protester to start this whole thing. Ratings were down on his show. He needed the cash. Bastard.
We've got enough to run with the story.
Oh, really? Well, I'm still keeping an eye on your friend until the rescue, just to make sure.
The story is going to be big. Huge. It's award material.
Oh, yeah. We are gonna be huge.
He's out cold? We ought to make sure he stays that way.
Don't hit him too hard, Sullivan.
Why? Capital punishment was made for a guy like this.
We need this guy to tell the world what he did. Don't give the slimeball the easy way out.
Fine. We'll do it your way. I'll stand watch first. He's not going anywhere for a while.
Great. Listen, I'll be back for the rescue. I'm gonna go see if I can find a high vantage point. Get some pictures of the military rolling in.
And hey, look. I got my goddamn money back. So now we've got until 9 a.m. to, hang around before the next mission starts. Man, fuck TK, right? Although I guess we do have to keep him alive. It's better to use diplomacy in, this specific case. Hey, BB. Sure, I have. Whatever helps you sleep at night. Okay. So now, we can go do this mysterious thing. Fuck you, Richard. Before we do that, though, I'm going to save and take off this mask.
Looking good.
Looking good, Frank says. You know, why don't I put the sports fan outfit back on, actually? Because I feel like the extra speed will help. Not just in terms of running around faster, but also in terms of allowing me to get other stuff done, you know? Because there are some other things I would like to do in this playthrough. But now that I've got my money back, I can afford the key to that sports car. Which is good, because I wanted to get that. Because that'll make going through the Royal Flush Plaza a lot faster when I'm escorting survivors. So I'm definitely going to stop and get that on the way out. Grab me some OJ for the road. I don't like orange juice. And every time I say that, anywhere in any Let's Play video, someone always calls me out for it. Everybody's like, how could you possibly not like OJ? And I don't know. I just don't really like the bitter taste of it. Like, I like sweeter orange juice, but like the pulpier, like bitter stuff, I'm not really a fan. I don't know. I've never really caught on with me. And if that makes me worse than Hitler, then so be it. I'll be worse than Hitler. Because I'm not the one that's wasting my time drinking OJ.
Hey, you looking for something?
I'm looking for the key to this damn sports car.
Order up.
Hell yeah.
I got a feeling you'll be back.
So let's see. We want to go this way now. Oh yeah, baby, come to Papa. Hell yeah! This was worth it. This was definitely worth it. Oh, it controls like shit. But you know what? Definitely worth it. So we're gonna be making good use of that from now on. For sure. Oh, it's so silly. I love the idea of driving a sports car around a casino. Now, where was this at? This way? Okay. Whatever you say, Arrow. I hate the select and start replacement buttons on the DualShock 4, so I try not to reach up to those if I can help it. Because they're really annoying. I think it's like options and share or some dumb shit. Something like that. There is one other thing I wanted to buy, but I don't have the money for it now. The soldier goggles. You might remember those. I mentioned those a long time ago. And those will be eventually relevant. But not right now. Right now, let us ride. I don't really know how this kills any zombie that you run into, but you know what? Fine. Some people ask, "See, Jacobs, why do you enjoy Dead Rising so much? Zombie games are tired." They were tired back when this game came out. And to that I would say, you are very much wrong, my friend. This game is as fresh as it gets.
Come on out, everyone! Come on! Get your ice cream! everyone! Hey down there, little fella.
I gotta go.
What flavor would you like, young man? Because I've got more flavors back at the car.
I don't think you're gonna sell a lot of ice cream right now. And I am not getting in your car.
Who said he was fighting someone? Someone with a camera.
If Adam was your brother, I'd hate to meet your sister.
How about a little ice cream, Frank?
Oh, boy. So, people who played Dead Rising 1 may remember... Whoops. may remember an insane clown man with dual-wielding chainsaws named Adam. Well, apparently this is his brother, Evan. Evan needs to get off his damn high horse. Okay. Yay. Special, truly. So, this fight is weird. Ow. Hitting Evan in the legs will hurt him, but like... The stilts? I don't really know. I don't know why that hurts him, but okay. Oh crap. Also, Evan has pretty good resistance to bullets, so Seymour's gun is not going to help us out very much here. However, I believe this guitar I've been carrying around will be useful even at this height. Yeah.
That's a beauty.
Finally. Glad I found a use for that. This is very strange. Just this, like, man, clowns are fucking weird, man. So, Evan can slow you down by, causing you to, like, hitting you with his gun. And then he can, like, cause you to slip on the ice. And, like, it can make you go slower. I don't know. Like, I mean, it's cool, but, like, what? Evan also has more tracking than a Dark Souls boss on his fucking kick attack, so gotta be on the lookout for that. Fuck you, Evan. Fine, Evan, you win. I'll take some ice cream. Oh, Frank, don't eat the cone first. What are you, an idiot? Crap. Oh. This fight is so goddamn weird. I'm spending more time fighting this man than I spent fighting a helicopter. So yeah, now I'm slipping and sliding, and this is just not real good. Where are you going? Come back here, little man.
Man, that guy had a short fuse.
It's not over yet. Oh, jeez. So this fight has now gotten even more ridiculous because now Evan is an ankle biter. I enjoy that his stilts were not the only fake legs he was wearing. This fight is so weird! All the zombies are getting in on this fight. Ow! Just die already, you little bastard. Oh, zombies, please. Ha!
That kind of cracked me up.
Oh, Frank. Oh, you're the best.
Damn straight.
Well.
Hell yeah.
Boy, that guy was annoying. That's a pretty cool fight, though. Frank holds the snowball gun in a very strange position. So the snowball cannon is basically a shotgun. It's basically a zombie freezing shotgun. And then we can do this, smash them all! And hey, now that we have killed 1337 zombies, because of course, we have unlocked the ninja outfit proper. So, let's go back to the safe room. Let's go back to the safe room through the arena, actually, so that I can stop at the Americana and make some more quick steps and stuff. Because I have a feeling I haven't needed them in a while, but I have a feeling I'm going to soon. To the Americana. Away. And surprisingly, we don't have any more quests going on right now, thankfully. So that gives us a little room to breathe. pretty nearby, we have a couple of stores I'd like to go into at some point, but those are gonna have to wait. Because while we do have some free time, we don't have a lot to spare. Because case 7-1 starts in quite a while, but if you look at the case file here, it's a long one. So we probably don't want to spend the whole time fucking around. So I'm just gonna make a couple here. I can probably drop the snowball cannon. I can probably make more of those in the future. Excuse me, frozen zombie sickle. Okay, I'm gonna leave that on the ground because I'm going to demonstrate to you the speed at which you move when you are under the, let us say, under the influence of a quick step. Nope, 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 zombies. You can see my axe there is being affected by the magazine I'm carrying around, which is good. I'm glad I have finally found a weapon besides the katana that is. So you can see, boy is he hauling ass. Ooh, did I just go the wrong way? Hell yeah, I went the wrong way. Whoops. See, that's what I get. That's what I get for not setting a waypoint. The one time I don't do it, and I pay dearly in time and loading screens. It takes a while to load the Fortune Park area anyway, because it's a very big area. Which is why whenever I go out there, the loading screens are a little bit longer, because it takes significantly more time for me to get going. But as you can see, the power of sports plus quick step equals, I guess, super speed, I guess. He's not really running. He's like, it's more like he's trotting, but like very fast. It's kind of unnerving, actually. I wish they had given him like a running animation that wasn't just his walking animation but sped up. I feel like that probably was not the best call. We also could go play more poker, but I don't want to do that because I hate poker. So instead of doing that, let us become the ninja.
This fits.
Oh, it looks so stupid. I think I actually was wrong, and the ninja outfit does not give you the boost in speed, but that's okay. Because of the tertiary ability of it, which is it makes zombies basically ignore you. Basically. They don't literally not even pay attention to you. It's just that they, I guess it just changes their reaction time a little bit. Because you've got the power of ninjutsu or something? I don't know. You have the ability to blend in with the shadows. Like a true, I guess, tourist ninja. I guess that's the look he's going for here.